Who knew the entire plot of The Acolyte would revolve around some Jedi beaver? The most pivotal character in all of The Acolyte is the they-them Jedi beaver. You heard it here first. We're going to discuss it. We're going to discuss The Acolyte, Episode 8. We're going to discuss spoilers. I'm not going to review the whole season. I'm just going to do Episode 8 because I cannot believe what I just watched. I am the man you may know as Z from Our Reviews Will Kill You. And do what you should do, which is like and subscribe, because we're getting closer to 2,000. We need your help to get there. So help us get there. Help us make some more of this good stuff. But let's get on to it. I'm going to recap the plot a little bit and make some points as we go along, because, and if this sounds like the incoherent ramblings of a mentally ill person, that's because that's how it was written. I have nothing to do with it. I may be mentally ill, but the person who wrote this is either in second grade or mentally ill, your choice. But they're not a higher functioning human being, because this show is just, it's barely coherent. None of it makes sense. The entire plot, I could barely even tell you what the plot is, because it revolves around what the plot says. Like, people don't make decisions. There are no character decisions in this. There are only plot contrivances or things that happen because the plot says they need to. So let's get into it. The end of a shaky season. This could be the worst crap I've ever seen. I need to digest it for a little bit. It's unbelievable. The episode opens. We're going to call him Smilo Ren. Smilo Ren needs to take the mask off of Osha because she's doing the whole witchy thing. She's never been trained on it. She's a failure as a Jedi. Can't even use the Force, but in the deprivation helmet, she could black him out and start mind-graping him. But that's okay. Not a big deal. She has a vision of May kill Soul without a weapon. Well, all right. That sounds great. Anyway, they decide they're going to get together and go to Brendok. And in case you missed it, I'm assuming that that is a guest appearance by Darth Plagueis, which makes no sense because the rule of the Sith is supposed to be the rule of two, which I think is incredibly stupid, which J.J. Abrams also broke in the Last Skywalker or what, Rise of Skywalker, whatever. I don't even know why there's rules to any of this stuff anymore, because nobody seems to care. Why even watch Star Wars? I don't know. It's completely dead. But then there's Master Venestra, who is, by the way, the showrunner of the show, Leslie Headland, was the personal assistant to Harvey Weinstein. And this is her girlfriend who plays Green Bean, Master Venestra. She speaks to a senator that we have never spoken to in the entire show and basically is like, get out of here, bro. He makes a speech on why the Jedi suck, because they're cultists who live only for power. Gee, have I heard anything like that in Hollywood before? Not sure, but I'm pretty sure I have. Everybody gets to Brendok because there's also everybody in these are ignoring the fact that there was a 100% pointless spaceship battle, and they forget about the Jedi Beaver. You need to remember how important this is. Soul decide, like, who knew there were ships inside of ships inside of ships? I did not know that the Jedi ship carried other ships. They never made that clear, but apparently it's a thing. So instead of just going down to Brendok together, because that's where everybody wanted to go, May and Soul get into some sort of unnecessary fight where they're going to end down on Brendok regardless, just to pad the runtime, and Soul's going to blast her out of the sky with like a photon torpedo or something, and the beaver intervenes. This is the same girl that he was attacking, trying to restrain, who like kicked him in the face, but no, the beaver intervened. Remember that, folks. The beaver intervened. So anyway, they get down and Smilo Ren and Soul immediately start fighting each other for no reason. I mean, you would think Soul would say something like, you killed my Padawan. You killed my friends. No, he's like, I would kill you for what you did. Okay. Sure, bro. I would have loved to seen Soul turn more to the dark side, but they They never really do that. And the fight choreography here was some of the best I've ever seen on any Star Wars show. You're kidding, right? The part where he does a Liu Kang attack, that was not good. And he pulls out his double lightsabers again for no reason. And then he decides to put them back together again for no reason. And I know none of them are going to die. So the fight was pointless. Like, another waste of time. Then you get to see Osha and May have their own fight. Osha was trained as a Jedi but failed. I don't remember hand-to-hand, you know, fighting be part of that. And May's supposed to be she literally killed a master Jedi and convinced another master Jedi to kill himself, even though he didn't deserve it for literally no reason. So anyway, Osha and May have their own fight, which also sucked. It was not that good. Hand-to-hand fighting, not that interesting. I love when they cross legs, so it's like crossing lightsabers. Completely stupid. So then May steps in, and, you know, the twins aren't twins. They're not sisters. They're one person sharing one whatever. Who cares? They don't explain it. Doesn't matter. Osha comes out, and she kills Sol. And then she turns her lightsaber red. Okay, sure thing, whatever. Everybody shows up on Brendok because, you know, they have to. Venestra senses Smilo Ren. You know, even though he has his helmet on, which is supposed to block thoughts and senses. No, don't worry about it. Don't think too hard. It doesn't matter. She thought he was dead, her former pupil, right? And then Osha and May, for what they were literally fighting to the death, and now have decided to team up. And Sol doesn't explain, like, hey, your mom was turning into a force fart and was vaporizing your sister. She was dissolving into thin air. I thought she was going to die. I had to protect her. Nope, I don't explain any of that. I just go, yeah, I killed your mom. I wasn't defending my friends. Like, the Jedi did nothing wrong here. And then, this is so dumb. So Osha may escape. Smilo Ren shows up and goes, they all could just escape to ships and go wherever they want. But for some reason, they decide to make a deal. Osha's like, if you give me my sister, I'll go with you and train. And at no point, Smilo Ren never said, like, I have a deal for you or I'm going to kill you. And then she goes, well, the only way this deal works is if you make her forget everything that we exist. And that May can't find anybody. And I'm like, why? Why? And then Osha and Kamir start training. They never show Darth Plagueis again. So he's irrelevant. Just a red herring to make us think something. Venestra goes back to the Coruscant and lies to everyone and pins everything on Sol, making him sound like a rogue evil Jedi. You know? Why the Senate would care? There are billions of people on Coruscant, and this senator cared about one murder. I'm sure there are people being murdered all the time, every day. I'm pretty sure Han Solo murdered Greedo and nobody cared, right? So why would anyone care about a murder? I don't know. I'm sure there are plenty of murders. And then she's like, oh my gosh, there are multiple murders? That would be like, I don't know, the President of the United States caring about someone who got shot in Chicago? Like, why? What? No, I don't know. None of that makes sense. And then Venestra brings back May and is like, help me find my former pupil. And then basically they're going to dump all this garbage on Yoda, and Yoda covered it up. So Yoda sucks, and he's part of the evilness of the Jedi. F you guys. Overall, I give this a 6 out of 10. Are you crack smoking? This is from Spoiler TV. While I enjoyed this episode so much more than last week's, I am still left with questions. I am not sure if I want a second season of the show. Exactly. There's no reason to watch this. The girl who plays the twins, she's a plank of wood. She's useless. She sucks. I couldn't tell the difference between the two of them at the end because they changed clothes and I have no idea what's going on. Like, I don't even care. I don't care. She murdered people, and now she's wearing white, and she's the good one. And the one who didn't murder anybody, except for Soul, for no particular reason other than she got angry, that's the one who's the evil one. They're all evil. You all suck. 6 out of 10, you are smoking crack. G-reviews. You should listen to more. Our reviews will kill you, personally. And then we're just going to go to my favorite. Favorite is a strong sentiment. As Eric Kane, I always go back to Eric Kane and Forbes, and I guess he's a kismet spirit. Sometimes we agree, sometimes we disagree. But Acolyte episode recap review. Terrible season finale despite cliffhangers and Star Wars cameos. He forgets about the beaver too. By the way, none of the Jedi would have found May if it wasn't for the Jedi beaver. So again, more beaver the better. Is Hedlund trying to give us a hint as to what her preferences are when it comes to beaver? I mean, we already know that, but anyway, he makes a good point. He says the show needed 3 more drafts before going into production. Very good point. I think that's what's frustrating about this. There is a kernel of a good idea in here, and it's just completely destroyed by incompetent writing. Like, nobody paid attention to where anything goes, or person X shows up here. Why are they're all going to show up on Brendak because the plot says they have to. Was it critical? No. They all had to return to the scene of the crime. And why did Soul do that? Soul could have gone back to the Jedi Council himself and turned himself in. But no, he took May, who he already told what happened on a spaceship, and was hoping that Osha would show up. Like, why did it get... Yeah, no, this is just, it's just not good at all. It's incompetent. It's incompetent. The Acolyte seems hell-bent on portraying the Jedi as the worst possible light. And he might be able to accept this because, you know, Venestra pins everything on Soul for no particular reason. Because there is no reason for that. But they didn't do anything wrong. May convinced that dude to kill himself for no reason. This witch cult created children out of nothing, and you're just supposed to be like, yeah, and they're force users, and you don't know what they could do. It's exactly what the senator was complaining about. He was like, at some point, one of you guys is going to go get crazy and super powerful. That's exactly what the Jedi went there to stop. They had these force witches doing crazy stuff with the Force, creating lives with no understanding of what kind of power they were going to unleash on the world, yet they did it anyway. Isn't that what the Jedi are there for, right? We don't ever find out anything about Smylo Ren. Nobody knows. He just does whatever. Nobody ever talks about anything. Osha kills Soul. They speak about anger, strike him down. The hatred is dwelling within you. All of this was incredibly stupid. Venestra is the villain. Yes, she is the villain because she's a liar and she's covering things up for no particular reason. And why is Leslie Hedlund? Why did she bring Yoda into this? You know what? Let's just say it's Yodel because I don't want to believe it's Yoda. It's ridiculous. We don't know that this is Darth Plagueis, but I guess it is. Darth Plagueis trains the Emperor, Darth Sidious. What happens with Osha? Like, who cares? Osha, May, none of the rest, whatever it is. I don't know. This is good speculation, though. I guess he's saying that his colleague, Paul Tassi, is speculating that Anakin was created by Darth Sidious, who learned how to use the Force like Osha and May. Sure, dude, whatever. I don't know. Does this need a season 2? No. Emotional apex of the show? There is no emotion. I don't care about any of them. They don't... He said this is not great acting. Just not good. It is not good. Here's some scattered thoughts, which I agree with. The Jedi and Brendak look like LARPers. Their costumes are absolutely ridiculous. They sound absolutely terrible. The senator who came in to complain It's dumb. Make Jedi suck doesn't make any sense. Why did the beaver sabotage the ship? Nobody knows. Doesn't make any sense. All of this is same thing. This is just, none of this makes sense. Who is this for? Who would like this? What fans like this? You're crazy. It's terrible writing. It's too dark for kids, and it makes no sense. Like, who's gonna watch this other than hate watching it, which is what I did. I don't know. Doesn't make any. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. I'd be happy to have a discussion with it. I'm gonna try to break down the whole season because it's just incoherent. No one has any motivations other than the plot said there was a murder mystery, and then there is no mystery, and then things happen, and we return to the scene of the crime. Like, really? That's what we get here? Anyway, let me know what you think down below. Catch our full-length audio podcast on iTunes. Catch our live stream Friday night, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Catch our 10-second shorts. We do them all the time. We review all sorts of things you've never seen before. So many reviews. We got you covered. You're going to like them. It's a good time had by all. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it. Like and subscribe. But I'm on to the next one.